Hi friends, today we are going to see a topic in which we are going to deal with eco cancellation over telephone channels. Now first of all, why there is a possibility that there will be eco, how the echoes are generated, what are the types of echo that we have to see. So in basic telephone system, okay, let us consider, let us say a basic telephone system. So how we, as an engineer, if I think, I will make it like this. First of all, I have two entities. One will be transmitting the data and second one will be receiving. Other time, the receiver end might be transmitting the data and the sending sender might be receiver. Because in voice communication, there will be no one side data flow, there will always be a two side data flow. Okay, so let's say I have entity A and I have entity B. You see AN path? AN path is a transmission path of data of A entity, and BN dash is the receiving path for entity A. Whereas AN cap is the receiving end of entity B and BN is the transmission of entity B. This is a mode in which data can flow to and fro, that is from A to B and B to A simultaneously. And such simultaneous both the direction data flow is called as a full duplex mode of communication. So in telephony, we normally use or we always have a full duplex communication, okay, wherein the transmission and the reception will be going on simultaneously. Now, what happens is in digital telephony, when we speak signal or when we speak in the microphone, we get analog signals. And analog signals need to be translated to digital signals. For that reason, we use modem. So we have modem A and we have modem B. The full form for modem is modulator, demodulator. So we have modem A and we have modem B, which converts the analog data into digital data to transmit over the telephone channel. Now, when your telephone signals are carried, they're carried to a central office, and from their central office, it will be carried to another central office, isn't it? So from the basic your receiver point or the telephone setup point, your signals will be taken, converted to digital, and then it will transfer to the telephone office. The data which is taken to the telephone office or in between the telephone offices is called as a trunk lines. And basically this trunk line are 4 wire line. So as I have written over here, 4 wire telephone channel. So what is this 4 wire telephone channel is? We are dedicatedly giving one pair of wires for transmission side and one pair of wires for reception side. So there will be 4 total wires. One pair, that means 2 wire for transmission and 2 wires for reception. But when it comes to your telephone or handset side, it is always 2 wire. So we have 2 wire to 4 wire transition also. Okay, that we will see later. But now the main trunk line is 4 wire line. The main telephone, carrying wires are 2 wire. Now in this, when we have 2 channels for transmission and 2 channels for reception, it is very good scenario because we have dedicated channel assigned for the transmission and the reception. So there will not be any overlay of the signals or there will not be any interference of the signal, isn't it? So there will be no crosstalks in this scenario. But think this, I have taken a very simple scenario where I have an entity A and I have an entity B, and there is a dedicated communication link between entity A and B. But like our normal telephone system, there is not very frequent or huge amount of traffic flowing from one entity to another entity. That is, there is no point-to-point communication always happening at the normal rate, at a normal non-commercial application. This scenario is only possible if we are communicating on having a transaction between a bank to another bank, okay, between one telephone exchange to another telephone exchange, and so on and so forth. So when the data has been flowing from to and fro on the channel between this dedicated line is heavy, okay, and continuous. But in normal non-commercial application where we use it for, let's say, telephone system, we are not always talking on phone, or we are not just picking up the phone and just keeping on sending data, isn't it? So there is a very infrequent communication or infrequent usage. So if I give a dedicated four wire system between two lines, and if the number of telephones start increasing, amount of four wire communication or four wire laying will be huge. So there will be a huge amount of four wire communication or four wire channels laying down process. So as the number of users increases, the headache on the laying machine or on the implementation part becomes more and more tedious. So it is beneficial to use switched mode supplies or used switch mode communication pairs. So what is this switched mode communication system is? Whenever you want to dial, whenever you want to communicate, dial the number. That number will be forwarded to the central office. Central office will switch your services to another central office, okay, which will be connecting to the user B. So now there will be many users connected to one central office. What will happen? Not simultaneously all users will be using the line, isn't it? So what is going to happen? The channel will be beneficially used by multiple users, and there will be